Next thing we're going to talk about are controlled tie-up positions. What you're going to find is that you're going to work yourself into a pattern of ways that you can attack the opposition. And a lot of the times, the same moves that you use from one tie-up position, you can use from another tie-up position. The first tie-up we're going to talk about, and again, these are controlled tie-up positions, is a basic inside control tie. And what we're talking about is controlling the inside position. You're going to find that in most cases, when you're wrestling someone and you're trying to get the best position, you want to be controlling the inside. So this is the first basic control tie, inside. You're on the inside, the opposition's on the outside. In some cases, it's good to have your thumbs inside here so that you can block his shoulder off so that it can't shoot through your inside tie. For instance, if this thumb is moved from here to here, now Rich has a chance to shoot through my block and possibly get in on a takedown. Okay, so again, inside control, inside tie. From this position, there are lots of different takedowns that you can shoot, which we'll get into a little bit later on. The second control tie position is your underhook. What we're doing from this position is controlling underneath his armpit. The way that you control this underhook depends on what type of technique you're looking to shoot. For instance, if we're going to shoot a high crotch, we may want to get the head to this side and control this underhook right at the shoulder so that from here we can lift it up and shoot in on the high crotch takedown. Okay, if you're looking for an ankle pick, you may not want to have this thing as tight, because on an ankle pick, what you do is move away from the opposition and pull him into a position so that you can ankle pick him and take him down. Key things on your underhook. We definitely want to control the shoulder. On some underhooks, you'll find that you'll have your own shoulder lifted high so that this will raise his arm up. For the most part, you want to keep your head on the same side that you're controlling the underhook on. This will block his head out and also give you a chance to attack this side of his body. So head on the same side that you're controlling the underhook on. Another thing that becomes pretty important is what you do with this free hand. In most instances, you will have this free hand towards the inside of your body. You don't want to give the opposition a chance to get under this arm. Now, you have no control with this underhook if he goes under this arm. So to start, head on the same side as your underhook, and this arm stays inside. You can reach out and control his wrist, or you can reach in on a leg, or do whatever. But the main thing is that you keep it in close to the sides of your body. The next control tie-up we want to work on is the elbow control. What you're doing on this elbow control is you're going to put your thumb on the outside, and the other four fingers are on the inside. If you reach down here, you're going to feel on either side of his elbow, there's two bones that stick out. Your thumb is going to lock behind one, and the other four fingers are going to lock behind the other one. You want to control it just like this. The thumb on one side, the other four fingers on the other side. Again, once you get into this position, you want to keep this free hand in close to the sides of your body. This is an excellent control tie-up position. Once you control this elbow, you also want to keep this arm in close to the side of your body. The closer your arms are into your body, the more power you're going to have when you shoot your takedown. If your arms are stretched away, you're going to have less springing motion as you go into the opposition. For the most part, what you want to do with your head is keep it on the same side that you have his elbow tied up on. So we're controlling the elbow. This elbow is in close to the side of your body. This elbow is also in close to the side of your body. And your head is on the same side that you're controlling this elbow on. There are many different techniques that you can shoot from that elbow control tie-up. And you'll see different techniques as we progress through the tape. The last control tie-up position that we want to talk about is a basic head and collar tie. Basically, what you're doing is reaching out and controlling the opposition's head. And if at all possible, you also want to control the inside with the free arm. So you have a collar tie and inside control. This collar tie arm, your elbow should be in close to your body, and you should also be using this elbow to block off the opposition. It should be right in front of his chest and not out here. Elbow in close to your own chest and use as a block to block him off. The other hand should be used to control the inside position. This is one tie-up that I do not like to see wrestlers get into and stay in there for any long period of time. What you want to do with this tie-up is get into it and use it as a setup. Head snaps, shoulder pops like that, pop the head down and away. But you don't want to get in this position and just stay here. Because before long, what happens is that he'll come up and control your elbow or somehow work to the inside position this way, okay? Or come over into an underhook over here and into an underhook, and he'll end up in the best position. So it's not a good idea to just get in this position and stay here. You want to move up towards the head and move him. Move him out of position and start your attack.